lovely people, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today, as always, we're playing with makeup. And today I have a full face of BH Cosmetics. I'm so excited trying their foundation. Only thing I couldn't find was primer and concealer. So those I will not use from BH Cosmetics. And I've got one new thing. I think it's new. Maybe there's more new, but I don't think this is the only new thing I've got. So yeah, I've got a nice little box of goodies, which we're gonna unpack with you all and just try it out. Oh, first thing I pick out is their foundation. This is the liquid foundation, BH Liquid Foundation Naturally Flawless. Let's get it out of the packaging. Let's see. This is what it looks like. I went for light rose, I think. Packaging looks good. Let's see. Oh, I think actually that would be a nice color. Let's see, yeah. I think that's a very nice summer color for me. Look at that swatch, that's really nice. Let's figure out afterwards how good this is. It's naturally flawless. Okay, so this is a new and improved. So this is a new and improved BH Cosmetics liquid foundation with hyaluronic acid that helps skin hydrated. The lightweight formula imparts a natural looking satin finish and provides medium to full coverage, which I like. Maybe I should have bought a BB cream because it's really nice and warm and limitless now, and so maybe that would have been better, but oh well. Then I bought something new, the Do Not Disturb palette. This is upside down. Oh, that's funny. So yeah, I'm keeping it. I don't know if it's supposed to be, but apparently this is how it opens. Oh, that looks pretty. Oh, that's not very much matte shades though. This one looks really nice too. So does this one as well. We'll see, we'll see. We swatched them all. Why not swatch them all? So, gonna go in with Getting Lost. Me Time. And Off the Road. No. And Off the Grid. Not reading very well. This looks nice. So, those all look duochrome-y. Can you see this? Those look really nice and duochrome-y. Even this one has the pearly white. If you move it, it goes to pearl white. And now we're gonna go in with Peace Out. Silent Mode. And Personal Space. Those look nice as well. These. I really suck at swatches. Sorry. Those are nice swatches though. You see these? Yeah. I really like them. Okay. These three did leave some on my finger. Then we're going in with Not Today. On Hold. And Don't Bother. Those are nice as well though. Look at that. Look at those two. Love, love, love. Look at that. Wow. What a shade shimmer. This is like a pinky purpley blue and this is like a brown blue. Oh. The weird thing is though that it's upside down and you open it like this. For me, that's the text upside down for some reason. But then it isn't Do Not Disturb, so yeah. So, then we have Getting Out, Me Time, Off the Grid, Peace Out, Silent Mode, Personal Space, Not Today, On Hold, and the last one is Don't Bother. Now let's go in with the next one. Oh yeah, I've got a matte finished pressed powder for on top to set everything. They had a translucent loose powder, but I wanted to try the pressed matte because this looks like the MAC pack. And this is supposed to be a light coverage, soft exoskull matte pressed powder smooth skin. So, sounds good. Oh, that looks lighter. Which color did I get? Just says shade 230. Yeah, that was the problem. I couldn't see the shade name. So let's just put it. Okay, it's light coverage. So maybe mix it together would be perfect because my neck is still a little lighter than the rest. So maybe then it works. Then I've got a BH liquid lipstick in the color Lust. Yep. We went there. Ooh, that looks like a nice color though. A nice dark color to go with my palette. Let's see. I don't think I have a color like this. That looks really nice. Brown, neutral, dark. Excited. Yeah, I think with the blues from the other palette, this will make a nice lippy. Then we've got Paradise Set Setting Spray. This is all new to me to finish my BH Cosmetics full face spray. So this is the illuminating setting spray because I wanted that and I want to... Yeah, smells good. So that's all that I bought new for this look. Then I've got already some false lashes from BH Cosmetics. These are the D305s. Like you see, I've used these before. And I've got my gorgeous blush palette. The Bellini palettes gifted by the gorgeous Heidi. Thank you so much. You're the best. You really are. My Patreons really, really are the best. And this is the Belgian Waffle palette, which we're going to use for contour and highlight and bronzing. So yeah, that's all I've got for my full face of makeup. So let's just try it all out. Of course, I've already primed my face. And let's hope this color works. Feels good. Looks good. The first appliance. Because I feel like lately I've done or too dark or... way too light. So yeah, this looks good though, I think at least. Let's see what this does when we blend it out. I don't know if they have a concealer, because I tried to find a concealer as well, but I couldn't find a concealer, so that's for the only thing we're not going to have. I'm just going to use my fave at the moment, but... Oh, that looks nice though. That looks like my face, but not exactly my neck. But then again, it does fit with my hands. Oh, I like it. Don't know if I'm not gonna do a wear test because it's already 4:10 in the afternoon here in the Netherlands when I'm filming this, so wouldn't work. And then I have to set everything back up because I don't have a filming room. I just do this on my dining table. But oh, it looks really nice though. Also the coverage. My nose, of course, always the darkest part of my face. Because it sticks out the most. But I really like it. And the coverage is nice as well. Doesn't come off of my nose. The only dry patch I've got is here on the side of my mouth. In a couple of spots, but yeah, life happens. That's with the concealer. And now we're gonna go with ABH Studio Pro Shade 230 Matte Finish Pressed Powder. So I honestly also have of this BH Cosmetic, I had one that I bought, was way too dark for me. But when I opened this up, it is still too dark. This should have been a little bit more pinky in it. I think I should go still in with a new one. maybe combine them. We'll see. Let's put this on first. That looks fine, I think. This is light coverage, because that's what it said on the packaging. So it's just actually no more mattifying powder, I think, then. Just a little bit color in it. Yeah, I think this works nice together. Let's get my small brush to do the under eyes a little bit better. And get in the crevices. Looks quite nice, to be honest. I think so. Am I wrong? No. Let's go in with the Belgian Waffle palettes for the contour. We're going to use the color Better. It's the one in the middle. I'm having my contour brush for this from Pushy Shop. And just smack the Better on. And of course they should work perfectly together because hey, same company. That's why I love doing full face of BH. To be honest, I had this quite some time in my house, but our family pet passed away over a week ago now. So I think 2 weeks ago. Yeah, 2 weeks ago now. So I put up the videos that I had finished after that and then didn't make any videos for a week. And now I felt like I had my makeup mojo back a little bit. But then we got some bad news from my dad. He has to go back in for scans and everything because he's got liver and colon cancer. So that's not that good, but I needed my makeup time. I needed my play with makeup. So no dark talks here. We're gonna just enjoy my makeup. But oh, yeah, I really like this contour. This is also the fault of Make Me Up Missa. She made me buy this, but I regret nothing. It's so good. We're gonna put a darker color called Cinnamon on my temples and on my forehead. The one shade darker, and I feel this is a little warmer. I think this is better for me here. So yeah, I really like this palette. It's one of my faves to contour with. Of course, the first fave is my Essence, but I do love that this is versatile. And I'll put in a little bit of Buttermilk, the light shade, to just hairline a little bit underneath it. So de-sharpen it and a little bit here, because I felt like last time I did my contour, it felt so sharp. Now it does it. No, I think it doesn't. And look at that, just, I love it. And works well, it should be working well with these together. And then my Bellini palette, what will I use? I think the only one I haven't used yet is this one, Life's a Peach. So let's go in with Life's a Peach. With of course my Kiko brush. This is pigmented, so if you've got this, be careful. Don't use too much if you don't like blush. I am a blush fanatic, so. Look at the colors. I love this. And I always put this on the apples of my cheeks. Everyone else keeps telling me I have to put this here and not here on the apples, but it just works way better for me. I just feel like that's where my blush should be, and the apples of my cheeks. Feels more normal to me. Because I think also my apples are redder than the rest of my face without me wearing any makeup. So that's what I like. And then we have to go highlight. I think I'm gonna use, this one or maple. No, let's go in with syrup. I've got my M501, which I came back to. I haven't used it in a while, and then recently I found it back again. I figured this works better for me than my other brushes. So look at that highlight. I don't get people that don't wear highlight when they do makeup. I am the kind of girl that wears nothing or a full face. But look at that highlight. Love it, love it, love it. Don't you just love it? Primed my eyes with the MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre. Because this is the driest one, and I feel like when it's summer, my eyes get greasier very faster than normal. So I need a drier primer, so that's why I'm using this one, because this one is drier on me. And then we've got the eyeshadow palette. I'm gonna start with Personal Space and put this on my eye. And I'm using the 223 Jessup brush. And I'm gonna do this nice and with you. And I'm gonna go in with a Winged Outlook. And let's pick this on. Oh, that's a nice blue. I need a different brush, because this one is quite round and I need a little smaller one. So I'm going in now with my M507. I wanted to use something else, but I don't feel like it worked like I wanted to. So I'm gonna make a wing with the eyeshadow. To be honest, I'm stealing this look from Sonia, who did a live with me last week. At least when I'm filming this last week. I'm not no idea when I'm gonna post this yet, but because as always, I have more to film after this. Okay. So this is my foundation piece, I think. It doesn't stick on as nice as it does on my primer. Doesn't have, yeah, there's also has a little fallout, but I can flick it away, so. And all that know me know that I always start with my face first, so. That's a nice blue though. Didn't do it on this eye, but unfortunately I have neighbors and I can't change it, so we're just gonna go in with Silent Mode, this gorgeous bluish color, because yeah, fuck's sake, I can't change anything on it. I can't change my noise, background noises. E27 Sigma brush for this, nice and small. Those shimmers, I want to put those shimmers on. We're just gonna, ooh, look at how nice. And we're just gonna put it on top. Ooh. So Sonja, sorry for stealing your look, your fire. But I really want to try how you did that last time on my life, because it looks so good. I have no clear clue if I'm doing it justice, but I want to try a different look, because I've done so many cut creases and everything lately. I feel like, at least. Again, the noise continues. How do people know that you're filming? I always feel like my neighbors know when, as soon as I start filming, they just go off. Especially when I don't do voiceovers. Every time I voiceover, it's mostly okay. But as soon as I want to talk to video and just talk to you guys and have some fun with makeup, they make noise like hell. So it does have a little fallout, but I can wick everything away easily, so that's good. I like it. Let's do the other eye. There's a lot of fallout in the pan. I don't know if you can see this here. But I don't care, to be honest, but just to let you know. So let's blend this out with this gorgeous purple one called Peace Out. And let's see if this does it justice, because there was a purple in the soft palette I've used, and oh yeah, this is perfect. To be really honest, I'm quite amazed with all my BH Cosmetics products, to be really honest. They're working very well. There was just 4 matte shades, which I would have liked. Just 3 shimmers and then 6 matte shades would be better for me, I think, at least. But I did make this palette, so the person who made this disagreed with me. I do like the way this is blending into each other. Really nice. And these colors are true to color. This is what I expected to put on my eyes. A lot of fallout in this one as well. But again, not on my eyes, so I'm good. So let's go back in with Personal Space, the darkest blue. Doesn't look exactly like Sonja did it, but it's the general shape that I wanted. Then we're going back in with Silent Note. Again, the same brush to E27, the blue. And back in with Peace Out and my M562. Back in with Silent Mode. And then I'm going in with my Creative Cosmetics pencil brush. And we're gonna start with the shade Me Time, this gorgeous blue, because I just have to use it and see how it does. And we're gonna put this on top of the, oh yeah, in a corner and a little bit outside of the color, the purple one we used before. Ooh, I like that. I like that color. I like that color. That's pretty, especially on top of that purple, even next to the purple, but on top of the lilac-y purple. It's nice. I always love putting on shimmers, to be honest. Then we're gonna top this off with On Hold. I'm gonna put On Hold, because I wanna use it. The end of it, because I feel like this is, oh yeah, a little different color. This looks quite something, but going back in with Peace Out, the purple, to blend them together just a tiny bit. Not in the beginning, because I feel like if I put it in the beginning, I feel like I just it just wasn't mixed together the other way around. So I like it. Then we're gonna put Getting Lost in my inner corner and on my brow bone. Well, an inner corner, I don't mean in an inner corner, I mean like around to my inner corner, so maybe a little bit higher. And then a little bit in here. Yep, going back in with Me Time to blend this in a little bit. Yeah, I just got to. Then I'm gonna put this pinky one on top of the, so off the grid, because also has a beautiful blue shift to it, just a little bit. To the side. Oh, that's really nice on the purple as well. On the lilac-y. Yeah. Mixed in. Yeah, I like it. I like it. Completely something completely different, but sometimes you have to do something different, I think at least. So let's go in with Not Today with my 230 Jessa brush. I'm gonna put this under my eyes. The shimmer. I like the color story, the peacocky darkened colors. I need a finishing touch, and I'm gonna put Don't Bother with my Morphe flat brush with the tip of it. Low, so not all the way down, but just on the lash line. At least that's what I'm trying to give it a little more shiz. Yep, that just give it that little bit extra. Not all the way down, but still nice. And I'm gonna use my finishing powder. My finishing powder with my 223 Petite Blender. I'm gonna just put this to blend this. so it's a little bit less harsh. I like it. Different, at least for me, different. I enjoyed this. I'm gonna put on my BH lashes. I'm not gonna do this with you. And I'll be back, and then we just have to do my lips, right? Yep. So I'll be back for my lips. So that's my eyes all done. These lashes, I think it's so funny. I have two pairs of BH Cosmetic lashes, and I tried Leslie on my look with the Utopia Beauty Bay collection. Tried different BH lashes. Those were awful to put on. And these are just gorgeous, so easy. I think that's so funny. You know, the same company made the same lashes, and one are awful to put on, and these are lovely to put on my eyes. Should use these more often, because I think they look smashing. They look pretty. I think at least. I like them. I really like them. Yeah, then the last thing we've got is the lip. This will be extreme with this look, but I don't think it would be wrong with this look. Do I have a lip liner to go? Nope. I think this lip liner is not the same color, but just to stay in line. I don't use dark lipsticks enough, but probably because it's so hard to put them on and make them look nice, but I do like it with this look. I don't think it would, if I would have put on nude, it would have fallen away, I think. It feels really nice. Nice color. Yeah. I like what I came up with. And of course, I've completely forgot the setting spray. Let's put it on now, who fucking cares? I know they always say you should put this on before you do your eyes, but cover your eyes, but I never do that. Just need a little bit more. Bottom. Smells really nice. Yeah, smells really nice. I like it. So what do you guys think? These are the eyes. How does my skin look? Let's put the... Stop. Let's put the lighting off. And just do it with, I think, technically normal lighting. But what do you guys think? Do you like it? I have a sparkly on my cheek here, that's gone. So, I have a full face of BH Cosmetics on. What do you guys think? I really like it. I really like the eyes idea. Something completely different for me again. Oh, there's a lot of lipstick on my teeth. I really like it. My skin looks really nice. Feels really nice. Of course, I knew I would love the blush and the bronzer palette and contour palette thingy, Belgian waffle palette, because I've used it before, but I love the eyeshadow. I used all the mattes, not all the shimmers, but most of them. No, I used the whole palette on my eyes again. all the colors are on my eyes. What do you guys think? Did they work together? Did they? Oh, the lipstick is really nice and matte as well now. And doesn't feel drying. But still matte, and I love matte. I don't like glossy. Glossy always sticks everywhere. I love matte. I love my lips matte and my eyes as shiny as possible. And again, I used all the colors. Oh, I love it. Oh, I love it. I don't have anything I don't like. Well, there's a pair of lashes I don't like, but I don't use those today, so, and these lashes are really nice. And their foundation as well. This is just my kind of foundation. Perfect coverage. Nice on my face. My eyes look beautiful. I keep looking at them. I love them. It is extreme, but then again, you're on my channel, so I don't do much neutral. And sometimes if I try neutral, it comes the other way. But maybe there will be a neutral again one day. I'm thinking, but no, not neutral palette at the moment. Still a lot of ideas of what to film. So yeah. Yeah, I can hold everything up, but you know in the beginning what I've used. I've held all the products up so often. I like it all. I like the foundation, I like the powder. It's a shame I didn't have a concealer, and in the end I didn't use any brow products. I didn't get any of those. I don't have a mascara. So in the end I had more than I thought. And no primer for my eyes and my face. I don't know if they have those, but I didn't check. But after all, I think BH is a big yeah for me. So yeah, please, if you like my channel, then hit the subscribe button. Give me a comment. Give me a like. It would be amazing. And if you want to be a part of my meets, then become a Patreon. You're always welcome. I love to have lots of people in there. Even if you don't want to, it's also fine. We talk to each other. We have a nice Skype every so often. And yeah, I love you all. I think you're all amazing. I hope you have an amazing time. Be yourself. Always be yourself. It's the most important thing. I love you. And bye.